is Erik Ydstie. I'm a process control person, but I got into this area of solar energy. The solar field has been booming. It won't solve the energy crisis in the short run, but in the long run, we can really see this has a huge impact. What we want to do is make the very thin slivers of silicon that are called wafers that's used in the solar cells. We take silicon in a big vat, we melt it, then it gets cooled and it solidifies and it's turned into a crystal. So you take a single crystal silicon, put down, spin it very slowly and cool it, so then more silicon solidifies onto the single crystal. And that gets pulled up real slowly and it creates what's called a boule. These boules are cut with wire saws and creates a lot of sawdust, so we lose roughly 50% of the very expensive silicon when we do the sawing process. We develop something called the ice machine, where we reproduce this idea where we feed in cold water, cool it from above with liquid nitrogen, and then pull out very, very thin sheets of ice, so like paper thin. Now what we want to do is to do the same for silicon. And what we're working on is called the horizontal ribbon growth process. Silicon, just like ice, would float when it solidifies. So we could melt the silicon in one area, have it flow down to another area. There we simulate the idea of a cold winter day, cool it down, and pull it out very, very slowly as it freezes in from behind. We hope to have a demonstration ready within 3 to 4 years, I think is a reasonable time frame. In the near future, we're going to see solar energy taking off in a larger and larger way and really taking over in terms of supplying electricity.